Next generation COVID-19 vaccine. Here's what to expect. In a short time, manufacturers have been able to produce safe and up to 90% effective vaccines against COVID-19. However, it does not mean there is no room for improvement. There are several angles where optimizations can be applied to offer the world better vaccines in the coming years. There's a long history within vaccinology of second-generation vaccines being multiplied and improved over first-generation vaccines. That's just the way things go, said Scott Roberts, Chief Scientific Officer of Altimmune. Second-generation vaccines are nothing new in research. These products usually come after weaknesses in the previous generation are determined. Right now, the biggest downside of current vaccines is across-the-board effectiveness in all strains and variants. But the world has to wait until next year before the first second-generation vaccine becomes available. To maximize the two doses provided by current vaccines, scientists must figure out if people need boosters. If so, when should they get it to extend the protection of previous doses? Dr. Paul Offit at Children's Hospital of Philadelphia said that if the novel coronavirus is here to stay, nations should have access to decades-long vaccines. Every year, people have to get their annual shot to protect themselves from COVID-19. To determine these boosters, vaccine makers must understand two things: the duration of immunity and the frequency of viral mutation. Vaccines are expected to optimally protect people from the original strain. But against variants, the situation becomes unpredictable due to mutations. Whenever the virus mutates, there's a chance a vaccine will be less effective, which translates to less immunity. According to USA Today, many scientists are now going beyond antibodies, the primary target of COVID-19 vaccines. They are exploring available safe options to leverage T cells, a second line of defense of the immune system. Priming these cells along with antibodies can significantly increase the effectiveness of vaccines, and the second generation is aiming for it. The issue is these cells are not easy to study. If they succeed, leveraged T cells against SARS-CoV-2 may offer longer immunity than antibodies. If both are leveraged, antibodies and T cells trained by vaccines can respond quickly to prevent symptoms from worsening. Besides T cells, experts are improving other aspects of vaccines, including storage. Some research groups are developing vaccines that can provide the highest possible immunity at a lower dose, which does not require cold storage.